Hello friends, welcome to my super learning channel. Today I am going to talk about some of the productive tips that I can share with you in using any spreadsheet. Let's get started. I have a sample data with me. So you could see the data is classified as zone and then the salesperson who is responsible for the zone of sales, like east, north, south, west, and then the sales figures for that particular month. So I just replicated the data so that it runs over to several rows. Okay, when I have such a data, normally I find an interesting problem: how to organize this whole data, right? So I suggest you press the shift key and then select the entire table. Go to the custom sort. Custom sort is a much improved option where you can apply the sort on multiple columns. Say if I want to see my sales by zone and then I want to see the sales by largest to smallest, then my data gets sorted based on the zone. So east zone has this many sales and then the salesperson. So this gives a much more readable data than the previous raw information, right? And one more thing, if you would have noticed, when I scroll down, I don't see the header, right? This may seem to be a small issue as we know what this column represents, because we have very few columns. Say for example, if I have 10-20 columns and hundreds of rows, it will be very difficult for me to read the data just by scrolling down. So I need to have a static header. For that I need to freeze the header row, right? If I want to freeze some row, then I need to apply the freeze to the subsequent row. So I select the row 2, because row 1 is the header for me, and then I click on the freeze. Now when you scroll down the data, the header remains static. So this is more useful when you want to read the data and I just sort the data by header. And the next option is, we all know when we have the raw data, there could be chances that we have a lot of redundant data or duplicate data. So in order to remove that, again I need to go and select the table, keep the keys pressed and then press the right arrow key. It will go and select up to the last column, so the row and column wise it gets selected. And there is an option to remove duplicates. If I click this, so it will prompt me what are the duplicates that I need to remove, because at times the name may not be redundant, because the same name may be applicable for different zones or within the same zone, but the the zone cannot be duplicate, right? So if I check and uncheck, it will show me the remaining rows and what are all the duplicate values. So if I hit the duplicates, all the 26 rows have gone. So this is the actual data I have created. I just copy pasted and replicated the same information previously. So now I got back to the previous one. And if you want to look at things in multiple perspectives, so this is a typical example. I just copy and paste it here just for the reference, and I select this. Paste special. If you see, there is an option to transpose. So this simply transposes the table rows to column and columns to row. The main advantage of doing this is I can view a different perspective of data without changing the original data, or I don't need to miss any information that I want to keep in my master data, but I can take a copy and then do this transpose. So this gives a different view, right? In East zone, Jane has made the sales of $6,000, and on the East zone again, John had made $5,000 sales, and on the North, Sheriff had made $4,800 and Smith $3,000, and on the South, Mary had made $2,500 sales, while Peter made $4,500 in West zone. You can read the same information in different perspective. So the transpose option is very useful. Otherwise, you will have to cut the rows and paste it. And let me take another simple problem. This is very common one. So assuming I have such a data, right? First name and last name are in separate columns. Well, we keep this data to be separate, but I also want to show that information by adding these two columns together. So there are simple formula which you can use. For all formulas, you need to start with the equal operator and then click on the first cell and press a space, ampersand. Ampersand is the concatenation or adding operator. So you could see the columns first name and last name are concatenated. So to apply this formula, you just need to drag till end. You can go and apply this. So without touching the other two columns, we have created a new column with this information. So this is more easier way to get the data perspective based on the availability options. Like I can do this with a formula, or I can even do this in other ways where I can write a macro and do this by programmatically. Okay. But the product tools that I am covering today is predominantly to explain you how we can maximum utilize the available options so that we don't need to worry about doing things manually repeatedly. Okay. And for the formulas, if you want to check how to use the formulas, there are a lot of options are available, and the formulas are also categorized by various function types, so you can learn more from this. I'll be covering more in my upcoming sessions as well, so stay tuned. And you find this useful, if you would like to learn anything else, please ask in the comment section. And thanks for your support. Keep watching, keep learning. Super learning. Thank you. Thank you, friends.